Israel's military said it's hit more than 1,000 targets in the besieged enclave. The attacks have eviscerated downtown mosques like this one and left over 120,000 Gazans displaced. Israel also says it leveled the northeastern neighborhood of Beit Hanun, which had been used as a staging ground by Hamas, the militant group that staged its unprecedented incursion into Israel over the weekend.
Israeli Defense Forces are planning a ground invasion, and they have already leveled parts of Gaza in retribution for Hamas's terror attack on Israel last Saturday. Now, nearly 1,000 Israelis have died as a result of that attack by Hamas, and the current death toll of Palestinians also continues to rise. The IDF said more than 900 Israelis had been killed since Saturday's assault, with dozens more held hostage in Gaza. It added that 50 families had been notified that their relatives had been taken as hostages. Gaza's health ministry said 765 Palestinians had been killed in the enclave. According to the UN, the Israeli bombardment has displaced at least 200,000 people, with electricity only available for 3 to 4 hours a day and access to food also restricted. Now, making matters worse, IDF, Israeli Defense Forces official Daniel Hagari told Haaretz that the goal of Israel's ongoing bombing campaign is to inflict severe damage to Gaza and not just strictly target Hamas military installations. He was quoted as saying specifically, "The emphasis is on damage and not on accuracy." So what exactly did Hamas think they were going to accomplish with this so-called resistance in specifically targeting innocent civilians in Israel? This is a resistance? Because they knew exactly what was going to happen. They knew exactly what the Israeli government's response was going to be. They knew that they were going to respond with what we're seeing in Gaza right now, where innocent civilians are being killed as a result. How is this a strategy? How is this a win? Aside from being morally wrong and absolutely disgusting, this is going to lead to more deaths of innocent Palestinians. More deaths.
Yeah.
They've lost, I mean, the international community and even the United States, even the US media, something that I hadn't seen in my entire career and finally started to see, was this openness and this understanding to what was happening to Palestinians in the Gaza Strip and the West Bank. Now the moral high ground is gone.
Gone, effing morons. So let me double down, quadruple down on what Anna's saying. So what was going through their stupid, stupid minds? Okay, you think you're tough guys, you go in with gliders, etc. Okay, let's say that you hit the soldiers and you did actual warfare against the soldiers. Already you're not gonna accomplish anything with that. What are you gonna beat the Israelis? Your military is gonna beat the Israeli military. There's a less than 0% chance of that. Less than zero, okay? So, but you didn't stop there, did you? That would already be a dumb plan. So you went and attacked civilians. You lose the moral high ground instantly. But not only did you attack civilians, you attacked them in the most vicious way.
Disgusting.
The most immoral, disgusting ways. I mean, there's now stories coming out, it's fog of war. I don't have all, like I didn't personally see the pictures, etc. But it appears they have decapitated people and they killed little babies. Let alone kidnapping grandmothers and children and wives. And
so I've seen
hold on. You got damn morons, okay? So not only is that terribly inhumane, like how does that help you, the Palestinian cause? You see how evil we can be? That's your tagline? You fools, you barbaric idiots. So what did you do that for? What did you do that for? So that all Palestinians can be smeared for the rest of the time? So that all Muslims can be smeared for the rest of the time? Thanks to your stupid ass, thanks to your barbaric acts? God damn you, Hamas. God damn you. You're so stupid. Now, what's gonna happen to the Palestinians? They're gonna get slaughtered.
That's happening right now.
And you saw the pictures of Gaza. And what is the world gonna say? Is the US and the UN and the world gonna say restraint for Israel? We're gonna try because I hope that Israel can rise above it. I hope Israel can get the moral high ground. I mean, the moral high ground would be giving up the occupation, and that would be amazing. But right now, we're not talking about moral high ground for Israel. Nobody's talking about that. And no one's crying over the Palestinians because you morons started it and you were such butchers that no one's gonna care what Netanyahu does inside the Gaza Strip now.
Can I just
So
share
all
an
those
example?
Israelis dead for no reason, innocent civilians, and if you're protesting the innocent civilians of Palestine being occupied and brutalized and oppressed and killed, how does it help to do likewise to the other side? Other than you just being like, I'm stupid. I'm just gonna do something stupid and dumb and immoral. God damn you. So now those poor people inside Israel, they got people that are in tunnels somewhere, man. Imagine your family members in a tunnel somewhere with these monsters. Okay, so my heart can't break enough for that. And so, but then now when they come for you guys and they kill all those innocent Palestinians, that's on your hands, man. And did you not think that through? What was the end game? What was the end game after your butchery? What was the end game, you morons? What? Israel's like, oh wow, they killed a bunch of us. We give up. Is that what you thought in your infinitely stupid head? All right, sorry, Anna, go ahead.
What Hamas is doing right now as we speak is they're sharing videos of the Israeli hostages that they are torturing, including one woman who they basically took captive while she was at that music festival. They broke her legs and they're sharing videos where they're parading her around naked. That's what they're doing.
You goddamn monsters.
That's what they're doing. That is what they're doing. So when the Israeli government would say, no, we can't end the occupation of Gaza. We can't, because if we do, they want to kill us all. They want to kill us all. They make that argument, right? They lent merit to that argument by specifically targeting civilians, by specifically murdering them, torturing them, and parading them around in those videos in the worst possible ways imaginable.
If you wanted to help the occupation last longer, you would have done exactly this.
Yeah, congratulations.
Yeah, congratulations. You guys are so smart, you figured it out. Oh, well, we'll butcher more than they do. We'll oppress more than they do. And then what, the world will trust you? Israel will trust you? Instead, all they're gonna do for the rest of the time now is say there are no peace partners. And so it does, and by the way, look, I know, and Ben Gleave and I discussed it yesterday, that when you have a situation where people are occupied, depressed, etc., it is not a great place for moderates. Unfortunately, people wind up clinging to radicals, right? And I know it's super unrealistic, especially as they get pounded now by Israel. But if ever there was a time for Palestinians to turn around and say, no, not you morons, someone else, someone that could actually help us, someone that could actually get the peace, someone that could actually create an environment where we could raise a family in peace and prosperity instead of constantly being worried about getting bombed and occupied, etc. Can we find one smart person, one person to and have the Palestinians rally around them? If you're a Palestinian in terms of the diaspora, for spend all your money, all your energy, all your resources on finding decent representation of your people so that you're not represented by these monstrous idiots of Hamas.
Look, I just want to be clear. My heart breaks for the Israeli civilians and the absolute terror that they've been dealing with. And my heart breaks for Palestinians. Both things can be true. Palestinian civilians specifically. With that said, I want to give you a sense of what the thinking is for the Israeli government, what the United States is doing in regard to assisting the Israeli government. Let's start with Benjamin Netanyahu and Israel's foreign minister. Let's watch.
We have always known who Hamas is. Now the entire world knows. Hamas is ISIS, and we will defeat it just like the enlightened world defeated ISIS. This vile enemy wanted war, and it will get war.
Israel's defense minister also vowed to impose a total siege on Gaza.
There will be no electricity, no food, no water, no fuel. Everything will be closed. We're fighting against human animals and we're acting accordingly.
The Israeli military has called upon some 300,000 reservists, possibly pointing to a major ground offensive in the days to come. Major Ben Woolhouse is a spokesman with the Israel Defense Forces.
We've cleared southern Israel from Hamas's militants, and now our highest priority is to stop the attacks coming out from Gaza. While this is going on for 2 days, absolutely non-stop rocket barrages towards Israeli cities, population centers, indiscriminately fired. So all options are on the table now in order to achieve that aim.
All options are on the table. The international community is, for the most part, rallying around the Israeli government for obvious reasons. Hamas is doing a great job in providing the propaganda that would persuade Israel, the United States, and its allies to support any military operation against Gaza. And as a result, President Joe Biden gave a speech today specifically discussing how the United States plans to assist the Israeli government in its offensive against Gaza. Let's watch.
So in this moment, we must be crystal clear. We stand with Israel. We stand with Israel. Like every nation in the world, Israel has the right to respond, indeed has a duty to respond to these vicious attacks. I just got off the phone with a third call with Prime Minister Netanyahu. I told him the United States experience with Israel experiencing, our response would be swift, decisive, and overwhelming. My team has been in near constant communication with our Israeli partners, and partners all across the region and the world from the moment this crisis began. We're surging additional military assistance, including ammunition and interceptors to replenish Iron Dome. We're going to make sure that Israel does not run out of these critical assets to defend its cities and its citizens. My administration has consulted closely with Congress throughout this crisis. When Congress returns, we're going to ask them to take urgent action to fund the national security requirements of our critical partners. This is not about party or politics. This is about the security of our world, the security of the United States of America.
Now, I don't know what this has anything to do with the security of the United States of America, but one other thing that's worth mentioning is it seems to be a consensus among, you know, Israeli officials, US officials, and their allies that Iran is assisting Hamas in these attacks. That is the dominant and growing narrative right now, which means that there is a pretty high likelihood that the United States will engage in warfare with Iran if it gets to that point, and things seem to be escalating more. Ahead of a widely expected ground operation in Gaza, Israel said it had fully deployed 35 military battalions and 4 divisions and was building an infrastructure for future operations. It called up to 60,000 reservists in addition to a record 300,000 already mobilized. The Israeli military says that it has secured its border with Gaza 3 days after Hamas's attack. But the Israeli Defense Forces said that it had also hit a total of over 1,300 targets so far, including more than 200 overnight, and that 4,500 rockets had been fired from Gaza. The IDF added that the bodies of 1,500 Hamas militants had been found in Israeli territory, and that the area near the border with Gaza was now more or less secure. I want to note, though, that those claims are obviously coming from the IDF, and they have not been independently verified. There's a lot of misinformation that spreads in the fog of war. I just want to give you that caveat as I share that information with you. But one thing is absolutely clear, a lot of people are dying. Gazans have no way out. They can't leave through the Egypt border. They obviously can't leave into Israel through the Israeli border. These people are stuck in a small area, about 2 million people, most of whom, half of whom are under 18 years old. And they are dealing with bombings. They are dealing with absolute brutality. And this is happening because of what Hamas did over the weekend. Absolute lunacy, absolutely stupid and immoral. Disgusting. What else can you say about it?
So now Israel is going to get more military funding, not less. So another one for the idiots in Hamas. And everything is going to get set back. I don't know when you could end the occupation now. So so Israel's going to go inside there. I'm in favor of the ground troops, because the ground troops are at least allow you to be more surgical. right? A bomb is not surgical. You drop it on a building, whoever's in the building dies, right? And as you saw from those pictures, that's already happened a lot. And so, but now again, Hamas has lost the moral high ground. They never had a moral high ground to begin with. The Palestinians had the moral high ground, but they've lost it on behalf of the Palestinians. And so now the Israel's gonna get stronger, and they're gonna be more justified. And then the last part of it is, there's always in the Israeli-Palestinian issue, who started it? It was this and then that time, and then you did this to the Al-Aqsa box, and you did the other thing for the this, right? No, this one's super clear. Like, yeah, Israel's had the occupation for 56 to 75 years, depending on your count. Yes, Israel did things that the Al-Aqsa Mosque said, but this is so wildly disproportionate that everyone will rightfully say Hamas started this. So when you start something, you can't be surprised at the reaction. And they damned all of those Palestinian civilians.
Exactly.
So did you go ask them, hey, do you guys mind if we go do this idiotic and deeply immoral thing, and then and then you guys will have to pay the price because they'll drop a bomb in your building and your kids will die? Do you mind? No, you didn't ask, did you? So guys, this is now dark times. Netanyahu was already super right wing. He could, like, we'll talk later in the show about how he blew it, but that's not how people are gonna perceive it. That he screwed up the intelligence. No, they're gonna be cheer when he goes and levels all those buildings. So Netanyahu and the right wing in Israel are gonna get more entrenched, and most importantly, hate is going to get more entrenched on both sides. So now the Israelis, if there was a strand of not hating Palestinians, it's almost gone now. It's almost gone now. So Hamas, you monsters. And for the Palestinians, after they get brutalized as they're getting brutalized now, they'll hate the Israelis even more. And neither side will see each other's point of view. And look, here I'll add last thing, and everybody will get mad at me. But it's arbitrary, stupid names and religions. Oh, we are Palestinian and Muslim, we are Israeli and Jewish. Guys, you're the same thing. You're human beings and you look near identical. You've been living next to each other for thousands of years. You're the same people. You're Semites. Who cares what label you put on it? Who cares? And the Israelis are like, no, they're not Israelis. No, that's it. They're not. They don't get freedom. They don't get land. And the Palestinians are, oh, they're terrible, evil Israelis. Let's go kill them and cut their heads off. Okay, congratulations. Hate each other forever.
And innocent people get caught up.
And innocent people always get caught because right wing idiots decide that they're gonna be, they have more power and they're gonna drive more hate. And half the time it's about religion. I got news for you, neither one of you is right. Surprise! Neither one of your religious figures is correct. So you're killing all these people for no goddamn reason. I know it's more complicated than that. I know that. But if you think religion's not a part of it, you're just kidding yourself to make yourself feel better. No. God favors me. Does he? He doesn't look like he's favoring either side right now. Thanks for watching the video, guys. We also love it if you hit the join button below, because that makes you a member. And members allow us to be independent, honest. We could be as progressive as we want. No corporate media influence. And that's all because of you guys. We love doing the show with our members. Hit the join button. Become one of the Young Turks.